Welcome to our video module on quantum mechanics. Today, we're going to be finishing up the WKB approximation and identifying how we can use the information we've learned thus far to do something useful. So we've had a chance to see how wave functions respond to innovative potentials, and we've seen how this affects tunneling, as well as wavelength and amplitude. Finally, we were able to use the airy function as a type of patch. But in doing so, we came across the complication of seeing how complicated those wave functions actually can be. Which brings up the question, how can we use this information to do something useful? Today, we'll be using the ideas that we learned over the WKB approximation and over the patch to find ways to identify quantized energy states for these innovative potentials. To start with, I'd like to bring us full circle to the infinite potential well. Here, where we used the boundary conditions to identify possible wave states which led to quantized energies. In the same way, we used quantized energy states for a harmonic oscillator potential to identify quantized states there. And if you recall, they might have looked something like this. Ground state is shown, and let's say for the infinite square well, we might have this as the first excited state. And for the harmonic oscillator, we might have this as the first excited state. So one might reasonably ask, let's say with this trapezoidal well over here, how will the energies quantize? And in fact, this is the real value of the WKB approximation. Remember that with the WKB approximation, we have to keep our assumptions of a high frequency compared to the change in the potential. And if we do that, we're going to maintain a constant energy, which means E minus V is going to be dependent on the potential profile. And from that, remember, we could identify the momentum. With the momentum, we discover a wonderfully elegant relationship where the momentum is quantized. Now, if we can understand how the momentum is quantized, we can then identify energy states for wave functions. And while I'll leave the derivation of this to you, I'll write the equation that identifies the quantized energy states based on momentum using the same principles that the WKB approximation uses. The integral of p of x dx equals n minus 1/4 times pi h bar. Now I'd like to point out a couple interesting things about this equation. First, we're using the relationship we've set up between momentum and the change in the potential profile. That will lead us to some sort of quantized energy states. Second, and what I find to be most curious, is this 1/4. Let's see if we can try and understand that. What I've drawn below is a potential profile with a wave equation's energy, E, in green, no different than many of the things we've seen so far. Next, I've drawn what a wave of energy, E, with this potential profile might look like, and this should be pretty much review. And as I discussed before, this wave equation will quantize. In other words, if we want to increase the energy, it's going to do it in incremental steps. But what does this 1/4 have to do with that? What this 1/4 means is that unlike the infinite square well, where we quantize based on the wave equation having to go to zero at both edges, here we're not quantizing to zero at both edges. Now, because of the potential profile, at here, we'll call it, we'll say point A, we are quantizing to zero there. However, at point B, what this equation is telling us is that when we quantize, let's write another wave equation. We'll make red phi 1, green phi 2. We'll have something that quantizes roughly like phi 2. Now, in this case, I've not shown the change in wavelength, and I've not shown the change in amplitude. So this is really for illustrative purposes. I don't know, I'll put parentheses around phi 2 so we see that. But what I do notice is that if B is the classical limit that the wave function itself will quantize a little bit off of B. Basically, it'll quantize so the wave function is 1/4 of a wave function beyond B. In other words, at B, the wave function is at some sort of maximum. This is what the N minus 1/4 means. So in the example that I've drawn down here, we would integrate from 0 to B of p dx, and we would set that equal to n minus 1/4 pi h to adjust for what's happening around equals 0. And in fact, we saw a little glimpse of this when we looked at the airy function as z got much less than 0, where we had a sine of z to the 3/2 plus pi over 4. I'll leave it to you to go through the rigors of the math of why this is a 1/4, but I'll tell you it has to do with the airy function. Now that said, everywhere where we have the airy function making an approximation, we're going to add this 1/4 or subtract this 1/4, n minus 1/4. Now we're not using the airy function here, so we don't do it, but let's look up at the innovative potential we came up a while ago. Here, if we have some sort of wave equation, and I've once again drawn this without the amplitude or wavelength changes due to the potential change, I simply am trying to find the locations for quantization. We'll say at A and at B. What we would do is we'd integrate from A to B of p dx, and that would equal n minus, well, it's going to be n minus 1/4 here, and it's going to be n minus 1/4 here, so that'll be n minus 1/2 pi h bar. Now, once we're able to identify the total momentum, which is basically what we're doing when we're doing p dx, we can use that to identify the energy states. What we'll find is that when we do the WKB approximation, especially when we're dealing with airy functions, the real value is not necessarily in identifying the form of the wave function, because as we've seen, that can get quite complicated. But the real point is now we can identify what the quantized energy states are whenever we're dealing with innovative potentials. Once again, assuming we're following the rules of the WKB approximation. So in summary, while the wave functions with innovative potentials may get very difficult, we theoretically can solve them using the airy function, the real value of the WKB approximation is in identifying energy states in innovative potentials, remembering that these will quantize just a little beyond the classical limit, 1/4 of a wavelength beyond the classical limit, as fate would have it. And in each location where we would have to do an airy function patch, we'll see 1/4 wavelength being added to the quantization. So if we have a bound state like we do up here, we'll end up subtracting 1/2. Thank you for joining me for this video series on the WKB approximation, and I look forward to exploring other topics in quantum mechanics in the future. Goodbye.